How's it going, people of the YouTube? So, a few days ago, I made a video featuring Anime Studio. It's one of my favorite programs, and right now it's super cheap on Amazon. Last I checked, it was about $53. It usually fluctuates between $53 and $59 right now. But this is typically a $300 program. It's fantastic for professional use, but it's also extremely user-friendly. So in the last video, I showed how to set up a character file and to create a character very easily and simply. But what I wanted to show you guys is how you could do automatic lip syncing. Automatic lip syncing is super easy in this program and can save you a lot of time. There are a few ways to do it. The way I'm going to show you is the easiest way to do it. It's not necessarily the best, by no means it's the best, because it still offers limited movement to the voices. I'm going to show you why, but it is good for more simple animations. It's pretty much just a few clicks and you're done. So that's what I'm going to show you right now.
Okay, so I got Anime Studio Pro open, and I made a face, a character face, just for the purpose of this video. So nothing too fancy, just a normal face. But what is different about this one is his whole mouth is a separate layer. Now this is a switch layer, which means that it has multiple vector files or images in it that you can switch back and forth. So right now it's on closed, but I can switch it to slightly open, a little more open, open, and wide. Now let's move that back to close. Now the purpose for this is that you can switch between keyframes which mouth position you want it to be in. Now the simplest way, the way I'm going to show you in this video, is how you can make automatic lip syncing. Sometimes it's not too important if the character isn't all that detailed, that you just want his mouth to move to the sound of a voice just quickly. It doesn't need to be too crazy, just open and close. Okay, so over to the layers on the right, you can select a new layer, choose audio, import whatever audio file you want. Now what's important is the way this does this. If you look at the bottom here, now you can see an audio file is on the timeline. Now here's the important part. When you're dealing with this, make sure that it is just a voice, nothing else, no background sounds or anything, because this particular way to lip sync is going to go by the ups and downs of the audio waves. So the higher the frequency, the more open the mouth will be. So if you have any other sounds going on, it will make the mouth move to that too. So worry about additional sounds after you've completed the character animation. That being said, also, if you look on the layers, you want the close to be at the bottom. So at the higher up layer, inside the switch layer will be what position the mouth will be at its most open point. So if you had closed at the bottom, it would work in reverse and that would look weird. Just so you know how that works. Okay, so go to mouth, go to switch, select sync source, and then select the audio recording, and then hit apply, and then okay. Okay, so now you can see the timeline switch. You can see that there are some keyframes added here. Now this took all the audio information and applied it to the switch layer. So let's give that a play.
Hey, I'm just a bunch of vectors.
Okay, and it's as easy as that. So this is a quick way to do it instead of the more accurate ways, but sometimes this is all you would need for certain characters.
I'm just a bunch of vectors.
So that's it. Super easy, right? So let me know if you want to see more animation tutorials, especially with this program. I don't think there's enough videos on this program itself. If there's something else you'd like to learn about animation or how to use this program, let me know in the comments. Make sure you leave a like. Share it with anyone you think it might be useful to. If you want to buy this program, that will also be linked in the description. Also, my wife tells me I do too many finger guns, so I think I'm going to make that a thing. I think I'm just going to be doing finger guns all the time. Anyway, that's it for today's video, guys. I will see you in the next one.